The history of classical music. Let's start with the Middle Ages, also known as the medieval period, 450 to 1450 AD. We had Gregorian chant, named after Pope Gregory. It was basically a lot of men in a big church, and they were all chanting, started out as one note at a time, sounds like this. Famous composers from that period include Guillaume de Machaut and Hildegard von Bingen. And then you had Guido d'Arezzo, who was very important in teaching how to read music and write the music down, the notation system that we use today. And then you have the Renaissance from 1450 to 1600. Renaissance means rebirth. It was the rebirth of ancient Greek and Roman ideals. Choral singing obviously became much more harmonious during this point. We had composers like Giovanni da Palestrina. Josquin des Prez, and then you had troubadours, which were singers. Maybe they had a lute, and they would travel from town to town singing songs to people. The Baroque era, 1600 to 1750. Everything got very, very fancy and grandiose during this period. Antonio Vivaldi is known for the Four Seasons, very popular songs. You know this one, Spring. As well as this portion from Winter, which was used in Wednesday. Johann Sebastian Bach wrote lots and lots of music. He actually did have 20 kids with two wives. He wrote fugues and inventions. He would do all kinds of interweaving things, like musical puzzles. Two of his more famous pieces are Toccata and Fugue, aka Scary Dracula Haunted House Organ. And Cello Suite Number 1, Prelude. George Friedrich Handel wrote The Messiah, which lasts for about 3 or 4 hours. It's about the life of Christ. The most famous song from that work is Hallelujah Chorus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Another very famous one is For Unto Us a Child Is Born. Then you had the classical period, 1750 to 1820. This is when they were starting to get a little more simple and balanced and neat and organized, not quite as fancy and grandiose as the Baroque period was. The three most famous composers of the period, Franz Joseph Haydn, who was the father of the symphony. Here's a portion from his Surprise Symphony. He was also the father of the string quartet, violin, violin, viola, cello, for much smaller settings. It was called chamber music. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, the child prodigy, was extremely smart and talented, especially at a very young age. He was already writing operas and touring Europe, playing violin on the harpsichord before he was even 10 years old. Here's Mozart's Queen of the Night aria from the Magic Flute, very popular. And here is his work for piano, Turkish March. And Ludwig van Beethoven. He was known for being deaf. How did he write music? He could hear fine when he was younger. He wrote music, he performed. And then as he got older, into his 20s, he started to lose it, went totally deaf, but his brain still worked fine, so he could still write music. And he wrote lots of great stuff like Fairlies. His Fifth Symphony, his Ninth Symphony, and Moonlight Sonata. Romantic period lasted from 1820 to 1900. It was much more emotional than the classical period. Everything was more and more. The loud was louder, the soft was softer. Much more drama going into it, much more stories happening. One of my favorite pieces ever is The Elf King by Franz Schubert, about a scary elf who comes to haunt a boy while he's riding horseback with his father through the woods. My father, und Frederick Chopin, a wonderful pianist from Poland. He wrote lots of very famous piano pieces, including this well-known Nocturne. Richard Wagner, one of the first composers who started to get away from the concept of tonality. Like, whoa, what's happening here? Where's the key? Where are we going? He wrote lots of famous operas, such as The Ring. Lohengrin. And Tristan and Isolde. Peter Tchaikovsky, who wrote lots of wonderful melodies from ballets such as Swan Lake, and of course, The Nutcracker. The Impressionist period at the end of the Romantic period from 1870 to 1900 was all about atmospheres and creating worlds of sound. Claude Debussy and Maurice Ravel were the two most important Impressionist composers. Here is some Debussy. Into the modern period, which is more or less 1900 to present, Igor Stravinsky, who was pushing even more away from classic tonality, here's a portion from his Rite of Spring. Then we have Gustav Holst, who wrote about the planets. Rafe Vaughan Williams, who wrote about The Lark Ascending. John Cage, who wrote 4:33, which is 4 minutes and 33 seconds of silence. And Aaron Copland, who incorporated lots of folk songs into his music. Who doesn't love this hoedown? And of course, with the invention of movies, we now have famous composers like John Williams. And Danny Elfman. I hope you enjoyed that. I really would appreciate it, guys, if you would like and subscribe and comment and share. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I appreciate it.